So this is another video that I've been wanting to do for a little while now. I have two of my 3-inch 357 revolvers, and both of them are, you know, two of the most iconic, I guess, brands that you can buy outside of maybe Ruger here. I don't have a Ruger. I'm working on getting a GP or an SP at some point, but this is what I have. So I have my Smith & Wesson 65-5, and then I have my Colt King Cobra that... this is a 2020 model, and I would dare to say that this was made in like the late 80s, early 90s. I haven't looked it up for the manufacturing date on that, but there's about a 30 to 35 year difference between the two. Today I am shooting 130 grain 38 special, 158 grain 38 special, and then 158 grain 357 magnums. I'm not going to shoot a lot of magnums out of either of these two, even though my 65 has a bull barrel. You can still really feel that recoil from the 357 Magnum. And because my Colt King Cobra is even lighter than my 357, it kills your hand after, you know, about 12, maybe 18 rounds or so. I want to talk about some of the similarities and some of the differences. Again, these are both 3-inch configurations, 357 magnums. We have the Colt King Cobra and the Smith & Wesson up here. Both are capable of accepting 6 rounds in their chambers. I like the Smith & Wessons a little bit more. I like the cylinder release on them a little more. When you just, I mean, you just have to like push them forward, as opposed to the Colt where you pull that back. That seems a little bit counterintuitive in my opinion, but you know, it's still a Colt, they're still glorified, and they still cost a shit ton of money. Running hoe grips on both of these, I think these are just Colt hoe grips. They came with the gun. I actually replaced the walnut wood grips on my 65 with the hoe bantams on here. I've done a video on this as well. Both of these have or double action, single action. Obviously the single action pull on here, man, I would dare to say is like maybe 3.5-4 pounds. I think I'm looking a little bit closer to like 4.5 to 5 pounds on my Colt King Cobra in single action. But I'll run them both. I'll run them both in double action and single action. And, you know, both stainless steel. Both of them have fixed sights, meaning they just, well, this one has a ramp up front and then the back notch in the back. And then this one actually has a gold post up front. You can actually switch that out. I'm not going to get too crazy here, but there's a pin right there that I think you can actually change that out for a fiber optic or whatnot. But then again, we just have the fixed sight in the back, the gutter sight, I guess is what some people call it. And so these old Smith & Wessons I absolutely love. Unfortunately, this isn't a pinned and recessed model. It does have a hammer-mounted firing pin, which I believe on all the Colts, they never had a hammer-mounted firing pin, nor did they come pinned and recessed. This has a frame-mounted firing pin, and I think that's the way they've always been. Somebody please correct me in the comments if I'm wrong about that, but I don't think they've ever had a hammer-mounted fire pin. And I know for sure that they've never had a pin and recess model of that. I have a few different Smith & Wesson revolvers that are pinned and recessed. I absolutely love that. They just look sexy in my opinion. And I have been trying to shoot revolvers a lot more now, get away from some of the, like the red dots, RMRs, you know, high cap magazines, suppressor height night sights, trinium fucking night sights, all that other jazz, and just take it easy and relax. And you know, I have speed loaders for these, but I didn't even bring them out because I just don't care about that. You know, I just load two and two and two and get on with it. Again, this is my range. Set up some water bottles. Have a couple paper targets and some steel targets out there, so we'll see what I can. Yeah. Anyways, see what I can hit. All right, so I'm gonna start with the Colt King Cobra first, and I'm gonna start with that 130 grain 38 special. Start off in double action on both of these.
There is no reset on here. The trigger has a super long travel in between where you're able to shoot again. I don't think you get that with the Smith & Wesson, but we'll see. I'm gonna try the 158 grain 357. Hang on. All right. Loading 158 grain 38. And these are actually lead tips. I believe that's what military and, law enforcement, like FBI and ATF and those law enforcement departments were using were lead tips back in the day. Let me try some 357. Somebody just told us that the bridge is being reconstructed, so I have to hurry.
The bridge to get to the shooting range. Otherwise, we're stuck here all day.
158 grain, 357 Magnum.
So did I. Wow.
All right. Because we're kind of in time crunch, I'm just going to go ahead and skip the rest of that and just shoot my 65. 130 grain, 38 special. You know what? I am going to run down the range real quick and just set up a couple metal targets.
Go ahead.
Double action. The sun's like right in your eyes. I can barely see my targets.
Told ya. But no, don't listen to me.
158 grain lead.
Puffing a lot of smoke. Wow. Huh.
Green, 7 magnums. Try and go for those two water bottles way in the back, the orange.
Okay. Can't Must be those.
I'm gonna load some more 38 special real quick. I don't know how great of a video this is going to be because I feel rushed right now. Not that that's an excuse, but I'm going to go for single action.
Those two water bottles?
In the back, yeah.
Okay.
One more time.
You hit it, it just didn't tip over.
You sure?
Yeah, it started spurting water.
I'm just gonna shoot metal.
Okay.
Pull on the Smith & Wesson is far better than the Colt. Again, you know, being a 2020 version of the Colt, they, I'm sure, skipped a lot of steps to make these affordable to the customers, because who would want to buy a 3-inch Colt King Cobra that was like $1,500? Feels a little chintzier than this, but, you know, it is what it is. That was not very good at all. Like I said, the guy came up and told us they were tearing down the bridge, so I was kind of in a hurry there. I'll do a chapter 2 with this.